गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रन, टुडे इज 15 मार्च 2021 मंडे। लेट अस बिगिन अवर डे विद द थॉट फॉर द डे। टुडे आई हैव समथिंग वेरी इंस्पिरेशनल बाय हेलन किलर। अलोन वी कैन डू सो लिटिल, टुगेदर वी कैन डू सो मच। व्हेन आई टॉक ऑफ हेलन किलर, इट्स एन इंस्पायरिंग अकाउंट ऑफ करेज, स्ट्रेंथ, डिटर्मिनेशन एंड हार्ड वर्क। The story of Helen Keller conveys the message, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. Let me tell you about Helen Keller. At 18 months, when she was just beginning to talk, she became terribly ill. This affected her sight and hearing too. As she was unable to hear, she could not talk. She became blind too, but with all her willpower and courage, and under the able guidance of her wonderful teacher Anne Sullivan, she learned to talk and write. She went to school and college and lived a full and happy life. Throughout her life, she inspired other blind people to find courage through her own example. Helen Keller was, and even today, an inspiration to the whole world. She showed that she could achieve through courage, patience, and struggle. So turn to page number 77, chapter number 32, Helen Keller. Now the question answers part of the previous chapter, Be a Netizen, will be provided to you in the next periods. And chapter number 31, Give Your Mind a Workout, is an activity based chapter. We can discuss that in our next Zoom session. So I hope you all are ready with the page and this is Helen Keller reading part. This is well adjusted now. So page number 77, here we go. This is the story of a child who became completely deaf and blind before she could learn to talk. Because of her own courage and also that of her wonderful teacher, she learned to talk and write. She was able to go to school and to college and to live a full and happy life. Helen was born in 1880 in a small town in the southern USA. At 18 months, when she was beginning to talk, she suddenly became terribly ill and very nearly died. When she recovered, she was completely deaf and blind. Now, let me ask you something. How do we learn a language? Your answer will be by listening to the language. Whichever language we listen, we learn that. But how can a deaf child listen to a language? When a deaf child cannot listen, she cannot talk. So, you can understand how difficult it was to teach such a small child the language, how to speak, how to talk, isn't it? It is very difficult for a deaf child to learn to talk. Most babies learn by hearing other people. Most babies learn by hearing other people talking. But the deaf child cannot hear anyone, so how can she know what talking sounds like? Many deaf people learn to lip read and they become very clever at understanding what other people are saying by watching them. But Helen could not see what other people were doing. She remembered a few words she had known before she was ill. For instance, she went on calling water Wawa. But she had to make signs for most things. She would shake her head for no and not for yes. A pull means come and a push go. But of course, she could say very little like this and she depended entirely on other people. Yet Helen had an active mind and a clever brain and wanted to do and say everything any other child would. She used to get into terrible tempers when she could not explain what she meant or understand what others wanted. Now, we learn any new language by listening to it, and slowly a baby, it listens to many words and then it starts speaking when it gets used to, when it gets familiar with those words. Now in case of Helen, it was very difficult because as she had become deaf, she could not hear to what other people are saying. Deaf and dumb, the children or the people who are deaf and dumb, at least they can lip read, they can understand what others are saying. But in case of Helen, she was blind, so she couldn't observe what other people are trying to speak, and she became ill when she was hardly 18 months old. So she could say only very few words at such a small age. For example, calling Vava, water, making some signs, but then she depended entirely on others, and the people who were around us had to understand what she wanted. And the times when her parents could not understand what she wanted to convey, she would become terribly upset, that is very seriously, and she would of course get annoyed. Then, when Helen was nearly 7, if you have missed your line, I'll point it out. Then, when Helen was nearly 7, Anne Sullivan came to teach her and look after her. This clever and devoted teacher changed Helen's life. Anne Sullivan herself had been nearly blind and had been at a school for blind people. There, Anne Sullivan had learned the finger spelling method. She felt sure that this was the only way to talk to Helen and teach her to say what she wanted. Because Helen could not see her making the signs, she would spell the words onto her pupil's hand. Helen had become very sensitive to the feel of things, much more sensitive than most people are. She could soon tell the difference between the feel of one letter and another. So this continued for some years, and at the age of 7, something wonderful happened in the life of Helen. Anne Sullivan came to teach her and to look after her. She had also been blind. She had learned and she had been teaching in a school meant for blind people. Therefore, she had learned the finger spelling method. What is this finger spelling method? That is, writing on one's hand is the finger spelling method. As Helen was blind, so something that a blind person can feel has to be adopted, and Anne Sullivan thought that the finger spelling method was the best. Since Helen had become very sensitive to the touch, so she could very soon identify the difference between the feel of one letter and another. Just for example, close your eyes and try to write something with your right hand on your left hand. Write your name. What you have to do, you have to close your eyes, take your finger of right hand and try to write on your left hand, and then you can realize that the way we write A is completely different from the way we write other alphabets like B, C, D, isn't it? So Helen could soon identify this difference. Next part of the chapter, in second part of the video.